20 years ago, my family introduced a system called Friday democracy meetings. Every Friday at 7 p.m., my family came together for an official meeting to discuss the current family affairs. 1 week we'll talk about what food we wanted to eat, what time us kids should go to bed, and how to improve things as a family, while another meeting discussed pretty much events that happened at school and how to solve disputes between siblings, by which I mean real fights. At the end of each meeting, we'll reach decisions and agreements that will last at least until the next meeting. What I just shared with you is a family story, but it's pure politics. Every part of politics includes decision-making, and ideally, the process of decision-making should include people from different backgrounds, interests, opinions, gender, beliefs, race, ethnicity, age, and so on. And they should all have an equal opportunity to contribute to the decision-making process and influence the decisions that will affect their lives directly or indirectly. I find it difficult to understand when I hear young people saying, I'm too young to engage in politics or to even hold a political opinion. Similarly, when I hear some women saying, politics is a dirty world I don't want to engage with, I'm worried that the idea of politics and political engagement has become so polarized in many parts of the world that ordinary people feel in order for them to participate in politics, they need to be outspoken activists. And that is not true. I want to ask these young people, women, and ordinary people in general, can you really afford not to be interested or not participate in politics? Politics is not only activism, it's awareness, it's keeping ourselves informed, it's caring for the facts. When it's possible, it's casting a vote. Politics is the tool through which we structure ourselves as groups and societies. Politics covers every aspect of life, and by not participating in it, you're literally allowing other people to decide on what you can eat, where, if you can have access to healthcare, free education, how much tax you pay, when you can retire, what is your pension. Other people are also deciding on whether your race and ethnicity is enough to consider you a criminal, or if your religion and nationality is enough to put you on a terrorist list. We need to teach people at an early age about decision-making and how to be part of it. Every family is its own mini political system that is usually not democratic, because parents make decisions that affect all members of the family while the kids have very little to say. Similarly, politicians make decisions that affect the whole nation while the people have very little to say in them. My proposal and advice is try out the family democracy meeting system, because that will enable your kids to exercise their agency in decision-making from a very early age. If you include your kids in family conversations, they will grow up and know how to participate in political conversations. And most importantly, they will help others engage.